You'll never go out on a training ride and dig that deep.
Awesome. We won gold. They're
life rides.
I'm like, dude, I'm still figuring this out.
I lose sight of the fact that it's whoever goes faster.
Yo, this isn't a road race. This isn't a mountain bike race.
The sensei of sprint, Todd Shesky.
My eyes are coming out of my head. Just get in here.
I'm here with Jeremy Powers. We just got done with the Ossian Giant. What'd you think of the course this year, man?
Mainly, I'm happy that I'm able to say Ossian this year. Ossian? Yeah. Yeah, last year was a little bit tough. I kept calling it Ossian, Ossain. I still spelt it wrong on my social media and the entire lead up, but somehow, like 250 other people made it here, so they figured it out.
Well, I think that's my fault. I think I actually spelled it wrong on the Reg page, and I'm an English teacher, so you can't really take the blame on that one.
Here's the thing. You know, you just put in best gravel event ever, and then this comes up, and then you're here. So it's Google it, done. The race today was fantastic. It was a beautiful day. I'm obviously in short sleeves. The sun was out. Big change from last year's very foggy and wet and cold event. So yeah, I'll take it. I had a good race today. It was a lot of fun. I was in the chase group, chasing Mike Jones, Curtis White, and Anthony Clark. Anthony lit it up on that first time up the hill.
Yeah, that's what I heard.
I was just like, okay, hopefully the chase group kind of gets organized. Wasn't a lot of organization. I like those guys, but not a lot of organization. And I just kind of at the end when we hit the swamp, It was technical. I had the right tires for that, and I made my move.
So you weren't able to sort of crack the whip and organize these guys? I mean, I feel like if Jeremy Powers says get organized, people get organized. Like, what's up with that?
I just don't think the legs were there. Okay. I mean, you know, sometimes you can cobble things together. Like, if you don't have the means to make coffee, you can't make coffee. You know what I mean?
Right.
So we got to kind of work with what we had. So, yeah, it was like that. It's just I don't think the power was there. So it was all good. I had a great ride. This is the hardest I've gone since the national championships, which were in middle of December. So I'm fully satisfied, and I think I got some great data so I can see kind of where I'm at. And the last 20, 30 minutes of the race for me were very hard, and I'm happy. It's a good progress. So fourth, I'll be back next weekend for Prattsburg.
Prattsburg, yes.
I know how to say that one.
With an R. A lot of people want to put the L in there, but
yeah,
the L will...
Plattsburg. If you go to Plattsburg, you're going to be up near that prison where those people...
You're basically going to Canada. Like, don't go to Canada.
Go to Prattsburg.
That's right.
And come hang out with us.
And it's a really cyclocrossy course.
I can't wait.
Except it's 55 miles. So it's a cyclocrossy course for like 3 hours.
It's going to be awesome.
But yeah, lots of rut, lots of... It's supposed to be a lot of rain, lots of mud.
Yes.
So I'm really curious to see. Dan Timmerman always says that's his favorite course because it's so technical.
I love it. I
can't wait to see these guys on it.
I cannot wait. I'm excited for it. So if you're watching this before that, come hang out with us.
420, Prattsburg, New York.
Ow!
All right, man. Thanks a lot. We'll see you next weekend.
Thank you for having me.
All right, brother.
All right,
where are your sleeves? That's the first question.
You know, I just thought, like, the shirt would just look better without them. I don't like being constricted. I like free flow. It's nice out.
I like it that way.
Yeah.
So, great sprint today. The fastest sprint we've ever had at this race.
I don't know about that. It felt pretty slow. Me and Curtis were pretty cooked. I thought he was messing with me, but we were both coming down, and I was, like, cramping real bad. And I see Curtis, like, hitting his legs. I was like, oh, man, Curtis is F2. And we hit the sprint. I was just like, I don't know. Curtis just monstered it.
Yeah, it was the first warm day. It seemed like everybody was cramping. Mike Jones said he was cramping. A bunch of guys behind you guys are talking about cramping.
I brought all my thermo stuff. I was prepared for misery. And then I saw the forecast, and I was like, it doesn't make sense. Yeah, and I just started overheating real fast. I was like, well, at least it's a nice day.
Yeah.
And it was all of our first hard efforts of the year. So we weren't even ready. And I don't know why, but I decided to just go on the first climb. You know, I was like, I'm going to settle in and just stick with Curtis and Mike Jones. Next thing I know, I was out by myself for like an hour waiting for them to bridge up to me. I don't know why I did that.
What did you think of the course changes this year?
It was awesome, man. I mean, it definitely felt like more than 4,400 feet, but that's only because we were going so hard, you know? But I mean, like, time gaps, you know? It's like, I don't want a time gap to go down. I want it to keep going up, you know? And, like, you got to go hard on the climbs because you got to make sure these guys, you know, you got to push them because, like, that way when they're on the flats, you can suck their wheel. You know, it's like you pull harder on the climb. Like, I'm like a butterfly in the wind. Like, go away, you know? Curtis is like a effing bull, you know?
Nice. So next week... Prattsburg, you're our featured guest at Prattsburg.
Really?
Yeah, man, featuring Anthony Clark.
Isn't that badass? That's pretty badass, man.
Yeah, first time there. That course is like cycle cross for 55 miles. I mean,
sorry.
3 hours of cycle cross.
It's gonna be
ruts,
sick.
Mud. I think we're supposed to have a wet week.
I'm pretty stoked about it. You know, I'm just gonna run the IRC Tough Guard dry tires. I'm still not going to go to mud tires. I'm going to bring my muds with me just in case because I like options. But, yeah, I'm going to throw a new chain on. I like to throw a new chain on after every one of these races because I just save the old ones for training. I like
that sweet pink squid bike. Oh, I love that bike.
Yeah, that bike is pretty awesome. Nice shot, buddy. Why are you throwing at me?
We're getting stuff thrown at us. All right, so we'll see you next week, man. Let's go to the party, huh?
Hell yeah. Sick!
So I'm here with the race promoter, Tony. Tony, tell us how do you think the day went, and just tell us more about your event and what it's about.
Well, I thought it was fantastic. It was the best event ever. The race was fast. I didn't have to actually ride, so it was very easy for me. I'm not tired at all.
I've noticed the people who make the decisions about the hardest hills that us, the riders, have to go up are the guys who are in the trucks themselves.
Yeah, I think that's usually the way it works, right?
Generally, yes.
Yeah. So what did you think about the hills, Curtis? How'd they fare for you?
For me, the whole course was awesome. I loved it. Anthony attacked like a bat out of hell the first climb. Mike Jones and I got together, and we were working together to kind of keep him at bay. Caught Anthony shortly after, and we were riding a hard tempo. Anthony was feeling good in the climbs. That was obvious. And then I think towards the end, we just started cracking. And then it came we popped Mike and just came down to a sprint between Anthony and I.
Yeah, that was a close one. That was like the best sprint win we've ever had here.
Yeah.
Closest one. I think next week, though, a lot bigger hills, a lot more mud. What's the strategy for next week? You got a whole series here with you and Ant in both all three races.
Yeah, so he got the big KOM points today. I didn't, so he's still going to be pretty close. And I don't know, just try to pick up more points next weekend.
All right. Well, we got a more cross-style race next weekend. It's going to be a little muddier, I think, a lot more ruts. So it'll be interesting to see if you guys stay together the whole time or if it gets a little more shattered out.
Yeah, and if you want to add some running in the course too or like some stairs or barriers, feel free to.
All right. Yeah,
We're all for that.
55-mile gravel race with barriers, running, and stairs from Curtis White. You're here to hear. That's what he wants in a gravel race. So when we do it next time around, don't get mad at me. You can blame Curtis White. All right, man. Thanks for coming. We'll see you next week.
Tony, thank you for your time.
All right, brother.